Hi folks, welcome to this short demo on Test Data Manager or our product on synthetic data generation. There are a lot of use cases for this particular product that we have within the DataOps suite. It ranges from masking data or having synthetic data generated for stress testing ETL pipelines or other tool sets. And there's also the aspect of creating test data itself so that we can use production grade data in our test cases. So a lot of different test cases that we create with this, and a couple of things before we jump into the actual short showcase itself. Firstly, the application is Spark based. That implies that we can work inherently with a lot of different type of data sources. And related to this particular point is the fact that the application can be installed directly onto your infrastructure as well, be it an AWS-based system, Google Cloud-based system, or Azure-based system, all integrated with scaling services like auto-scaling, Kubernetes, Databricks, and so on. Now, let's assume that you want to create production-grade data. So you define your connections to any of these, as you can see. There's a lot of nuance here as well with regards to integrations with your credential management service and other systems. But once you have defined your connection, we move into the Test Data Manager. So I'm going to go ahead and use an existing example to save time here, where, as you can see, a few tables have already been imported. The import process is very straightforward. Just define exactly what tables you would like to go ahead with. And within the import, the application is going to do a lot of things at once. It's going to understand what the primary keys of the tables are, primary and foreign keys, to understand the relationship between tables, as this is an important relation that has to be maintained within the synthetic data as well. And along with that, if you look at this demographic specific data, dim customer, it's also going to try to find out PII entities inherently. The reason for this is going to come in handy shortly, but the main gist here is that the application does a first pass of finding out any PII entities. And if you would like to, you can define something as a PII entity as well. For a particular reason, if I want to say skip this particular total children out, I can define that as an entity and work it and associate that with the corresponding entity as defined here.
For further questions, feel free to reach contact at datagaps.com. Request a free demo, scan the QR code below. Thank you.